under the lights here in El Paso, 28-13 against the Miners as we get ready for the start of the third quarter. Last week, Colt McCoy was 24 of 29. This week, Bob Davey, 14 of 16, three touchdowns. The meter still running.
Impressive. I mean, overall, you mentioned it, 14 for 16. Look at the deep balls, the passes over 15 yards, 3 for 3. UTEP has given up. Now, it's been a combination of a very good Colt McCoy, speed at wide receiver with Quan Cosby, but also some broken coverages with this new scheme that's been implemented here at El Paso. But just an impressive start. First game, first half of the second game for Colt McCoy.
Jose Martinez will kick off. Texas will receive. They deferred for the second half. Surprisingly, Martinez unable to kick it out of the end zone like he did on the previous two. Shipley on the kickoff return out to the 17-yard line. I'm Mark Jones along with Bob Davey. This is the third meeting all time between these two teams. The last time they met was 1933. But, Bob, how does the Miners, how do they get back into this game? They've been able to move the ball offensively, haven't been able to slow down Texas.
Yeah, Mark, and it's tough because UTEP has committed to the 3-3-5 blitz defense, creating pressure. When you do that, you have to be able to cover one-on-one out there in those wide receivers. The truth is they haven't gotten great pressure because Colt McCoy can move around and scramble, and they have not been able to cover particularly Quan Cosby. So they have to force some turnovers because they cannot consistently defend this Texas offense.
And the beat goes on for Cosby, who picks up 7 yards on that reception. Quan Cosby had a touchdown catch in the first half. Former Texas High School State sprint champion, former professional baseball player, was a member of the Anaheim Angels at the time. They were Anaheim, now they're Los Angeles, of course. Drafted in 2001, 25 years old. Has experience on his side. Second and three. And the give is to Vondrell McGee, and McGee gets the first down.
Mark, the reality is, and the truth of it is, this Texas offense is much better, much more experienced than this UTEP defense. I mean, go back a week ago to Buffalo. UTEP gave up 42 points, 484 yards. So let's be honest. It's going to take a combination of Texas not executing, stopping themselves, and maybe a big play by UTEP. But at some point, you have to eliminate the big home run plays.
UTEP coming with a little pressure here. McCoy gets it off in time and defended well that time, intended for Quan Cosby. And number two, Josh Ferguson, bumping his gums a little bit with Cosby. Hasn't had an opportunity to talk too much tonight.
And UTEP is not backing off, Mark. This is just straight man-to-man coverage, nobody in the middle of the field. And this time UTEP does an excellent job of just covering right there. But, man, that is high risk, high reward. But that is going to be their style of defense under Jose Lewis right here.
Came over from New Mexico. Second and 10. McCoy looking up top. Has a man open. Oh. And what a catch by Quan Cosby. They give it to the offense. And he got in behind Cornelius Brown for just a moment to make the catch.
And this time it is just zone coverage, three deep. But this is as good as you can throw it. A little double move right there by Quan Cosby. But good coverage by Cornelius Brown. But Mark, notice Cornelius Brown never looked back to the football. But wow, what a throw by Colt McCoy.
That's the seventh reception today for Quan Cosby. And McCoy's numbers continue to pile up as well.
That's pretty impressive. 40 for 48 for 456 yards.
And you can elude a little bit of heat, too. Downfield and incomplete. Pass is incomplete. That one intended for Malcolm Williams, who seemed to slip.
And just so the fans that understand at home, because UTEP plays a lot of three deep or man-free coverage, those corners are on their own. They don't really have a way to double cover the wide receivers and play with two safeties back. They only play with one safety. So those corners are on their own.
Melvin Stevenson and Cornelius Brown, a couple of junior corners. Second down and 10 coming up for the Texas Longhorns. Ball at the 16. And there was a roughing the passer penalty called on that last play, which moves the ball to the 16-yard line. Over the left side, that was Fozzie Whitaker, who missed last week's game with an ankle injury. Let's take one more look at that last penalty.
Yeah, I thought this flag came out late. Boy, Mark, what'd you think? Pony Matu, the linebacker, number 7.
He might have gotten there a little bit late.
Yeah.
And Ferguson a little shaken up. Josh Ferguson, the 5'9 senior. It was interesting. Mike Price, that coach, met with him earlier this week, kind of take the pulse of the team, find out where everyone's head was at. And Ferguson's report was pretty good. He told Coach Price, hey, the 16 freshmen that are playing, they're dealing with this Texas week pretty well. They're ready to go.
Right there, you look at Osei Lewis. I mean, there is nowhere to hide right now because your scheme is one-on-one with those corners, and right now they can't cover.
Second and 8, and McCoy fires high, intended for his tight end. It's incomplete.
What happens when you have a defense that's based on confusion and movement, and you have a quarterback like Colt McCoy that's very experienced and elusive, all of a sudden you just can't get the pressure on him that you anticipated, and you really hang those DBs out there. But big third down here for this UTEP defense. See if they can step up and make a play. Right,
third
here.
Down and 8. Chris Obanaya in the ball game.
Here's Cosby down here, one-on-one with the corner.
Matched up against Melvin Stevenson. McCoy goes the other way into the end zone, and it's picked off. So a measure of revenge by Cornelius Brown, who was victimized a couple plays ago.
And there's no question Cornelius Brown deserved that one, Mark. He matches up much better with Dan Buckner at 6'4", 213, than he does with Quan Cosby. And that is the turnover that UTEP needed. But look right here. That's pretty good technique, even though Cornelius Brown wants to look back in the backfield. But that is the mistake that UTEP had to have Texas make.
So they turned Texas over on that series. And that's McCoy's first interception of the season. See what the Miners can do with it coming back the other way. First down and 10 from the 20. Set up the screen. Vitito to Jackson. Jackson got a nice kickout block and got close to the first down, just shy of the 30-yard line. Second down and short coming up for UTEP.
Great block out here by the offensive guard, number 74, Rod Huntley, at 310 pounds. I mean, that was a great job in the open field by the big guy.
He made a pancake out of Bobbino. Second and short coming up. Hunt in motion. And off to Jackson. And Jackson showed no love on that one. Stopped up short of the line of scrimmage. Sets up a third down and about one to go. Bobbino and Miller in on the play.
Rashad Bobbino, excellent football player. Four-year starter in Texas as a linebacker. You look there, 5'11", 230. Just a real explosive player. Key third down right here for UTEP. Do not put that defense back on the field. You have to create a first down, convert a first down right here.
And missing from Texas's defense is Lamar Houston, suspended for a week by the head coach, the result of his DUI infraction and charge this week. He apologized to the team. It is third and short, and it is complete. They pick up the first down at the 34-yard line. Jeff Maturi makes the catch, picking up 5 on the play. Mike Price can't believe it.
Well, Mike's son, Aaron Price, is now the offensive coordinator. His other son, Eric, who's the offensive coordinator a year ago, left and went to the NFL. So they keep it all in the family here with Mike Price now.
Mike Price in his 5th year here at UTEP, trying to rebound from a 4-8 season. They've actually lost 7 consecutive games going back to last year. On first and 10, Benito escapes harm's way. Caught but out of bounds that time by Davis.
But you have to love Mike Preston. I mean, you enjoy every time you're around him. You take a look at Aaron up in the press box. But Mike Price will have some fun with it. I remember a couple years ago when they accepted the bowl bid to the GMAC Bowl. Mike Price comes in the locker room. The team's in the locker room. He has a top hat, a bowling shirt, a bowling glove, and a bowling bat. And he pulls out the bowling ball and he rolls it down the locker room and says, "We're going bowling, boys."
You gotta love
and the place
it.
Went crazy. I mean, he has always had some great innovative ideas.
Love those props. Second down and 10. Oh, nice cut by Jackson at the line of scrimmage. Wow, nice move. Got all the way out to the 38-yard line, brought down by Gideon. Gained 5 on the play. But getting back one more time, Bob, to Lamar Houston. Mack Brown, the head coach of Texas, told us that it was very and is very uncharacteristic of Lamar Houston to do what happened last week. Houston came in, spoke to the team en masse last week, was very emotional, was in tears at one point, apologized to the team, a heartfelt apology, and his teammates welcoming him back with open arms. He's expected to return sometime soon. Third down and 5. Benito tried to take off, but was chopped down on the play from behind by Sergio Kindle. He picked up 3, but is short of the first down. So after the interception, they're looking at a fourth down now.
The speed of Sergio Kindle. Watch him right up here at the top, number 2. He's on the pass rush, just spins out and tracks Benito down. He is going to be an impact player as this season develops, particularly as a pass rusher. And here's the big problems for UTEP, punting this football right here.
Got issues with their long snapper, Jamar Hunt. And Peterson has had troubles hanging onto the ball when it hits him in the hands. This one was a little bit wide. Boy, every punt is an adventure for UTEP. Caught at the 20-yard line. Cosby. And Cosby makes it out beyond the 35 to the 37-yard line. Texas with the lead. After that 38-yard punt, fly the flag in Texas. Of Texas, you know that there's boundless talent on the football field to follow. And we'll be telling you about that in just a few moments. Just one of the things that we have in the hopper to talk about tonight.
You realize how big this state is? It's 580 miles from El Paso to Austin. It was an hour and a half flight to get out here for a long time. I mean, Texas is like 3 or 4 states.
You never want to drive from one end to the other. Have you done it?
I have not.
Brett McCoy on first down and 10. Under a little bit of heat. And McCoy lowered his shoulder and delivered a little bit of a blow. Miller made the stop on the play along with Wilkins.
No gain.
Mike Price said he was not going to use the chip on the shoulder motivation of Texas did not recruit us when he talked to his El Paso player. Said he was going to take the positive approach. You know, a lot of coaches do that when they play the big state school. They talk about, well, Texas didn't offer you. I think that provides motivation to their guys.
Second down and 10. Little receiver screen, incomplete. That's picked. Never touched the ground. It bounced up. And UTEP has it in Texas territory. Jordan Shipley was the intended receiver. And this might be one up for review.
I think so. I believe this football hit the ground. The little jailbreak out there to Shipley.
Oh, yeah.
The ball bounced clearly off the ground. Ola Locken picked it up.
Now this one's going to come back.
It's going to be obviously overturned. It will be an incomplete pass.
I could have swore I saw that pass. But we're pretty high up here at the Sun Bowl. Mack Brown is livid. He's waiting for the game to be stopped, and now it is.
Previous plays under review.
Isn't that the great thing about instant replay? That could have been a game-changing play right there. Clearly that ball bounced off the ground. I'm surprised they missed that live.
Somebody had to be blocked out on that play.
Exactly.
Thank goodness for instant replay. They could have used it in that Washington BYU game today, but that's another.
The ruling is an incomplete pass. It'll be third down at the 36.
That was a pretty easy one to call.
It really was. Clearly, Jordan Shipley did not have control of the football. And obviously, the ball bounced off the turf three or four times. But the key for UTEP defense right now, you talk about short memory. Bounce back right now. You've got a third and 10. The crowd is energized. This is a key third down. And somehow, double cover number six, Quan Cosby.
That's been McCoy's favorite target tonight. McCoy, interestingly enough, now has missed on his last four pass attempts.
And here's the matchup. Here's Quan Cosby. Here's Melvin Stevenson. And he is not going to have help from any safety in here. So he is going to be on his own right now.
Well, Cornelius Brown came up with a nice play
last time. Cornelius is not going to get his shot up here, Mark.
And Texas calls a timeout.
Timeout, Texas. They're first of the half.
We're going to
talent here in the state.
Well, Mac Brown is livid over something still. Third down and 10 coming up for McCoy. Nobody home, and he's sacked back at the 30-yard line by Cromartie Smith, and the Miners hold.
A great changeup by Osei Lewis. I want you to watch on the all 22 what he did. He actually slid the coverage over and double covered. Here's the corner rolled up. Here's the safety. They have not done this the whole game. So they put two guys on Quan Cosby right here and forced Colt McCoy to go somewhere else. That's the first snap of two safety look they played all night. They get a big pressure out of their defensive front.
Meanwhile, Gold now standing to punt from his own 17-yard line. Jeff Maturi, low snap, and nobody there to put the heat on him. Maturi watches it bounce, and he takes it on the fly. And Maturi goes down at the 40-yard line.
Think,
good field position for UTEP.
I think UTEP lined up offsides. I think the widest guy in their punt rush lined up across the neutral zone.
Early in the season, you often see the kicking game being the weak link where most errors are made.
You know, I might have missed that. They're looking over there at UTEP. UTEP's probably going to decline this. It may be an illegal formation or something.
Illegal formation on the kicking team. Six men on the line of scrimmage. That penalty being forced at the end of the kick. It is first down.
Mac Brown's brow getting a little bit more moon tonight. So strange things can happen. It doesn't have to be a full moon. And a look from high, high above the Sun Bowl here in El Paso, Texas. Amongst the Franklin Mountains. First down and 10 for the Miners. Draw play, Jackson swallowed, devoured by the defensive front led by Brian Arakpo. But back to the recruiting aspect. Arakpo, one of several Texas players on that Longhorn roster. And the numbers that come out of the different states.
Yeah,
Texas,
I mean,
Florida, California.
Yeah, that's the three biggest. But I think the astonishing fact, we look at Roy Miller down on the field right here for Texas. That would be a huge, huge loss. But Mark, just in the Big 12 conference alone, Oklahoma State, Oklahoma, Missouri, Nebraska, Iowa State, and Kansas all signed more players from the state of Texas last year than they signed from their home state. I mean, that is an incredible statistic right there. So a lot of people talk about the reemergence, particularly of the Big 12 North. Look at the numbers. That's four schools right there, Missouri, Nebraska, Iowa State, and Kansas, from the Big 12 North that signed more players from Texas than their home state.
Okay.
So the fact that the high school coaching and football and talent in Texas is so strong, that's why the Big 12 has reemerged itself.
Right. And Bob, that's Roy Miller up off the turf now. Really one of the anchors up front. Healthy again this year. A year ago, he was recovering from shoulder surgery. Never really was healthy for most of the year. He's back to bench pressing about 500 pounds, unlike last year when he could do only about 200. He said he felt like a place kicker.
He is a powerful, powerful guy. And you mentioned it. Benches 500, squats 620. It's going to take a lot to hurt him.
That's second down and 14. Vito's got to make something happen here. Stands in the pocket, and it's broken up, incomplete. That was intended for number six, Maturi. Ryan Palmer broke it up. And Bob, back to what we were talking about. Tell me about your experiences recruiting Texas as to recruiting other states. How is it different?
It's a great place to recruit because you go in these high schools, all these coaches, you can find them immediately because a lot of them have their own football buildings. A lot of the coaches in Texas don't teach. So you're going to find the high school coach when you go in. So you don't waste a lot of time. Super organized, super facilities. I think it's the best state in the country to recruit in.
There's Vidito. Incomplete, bounces off the hands of his intended receiver, Maturi, who's slow to get up. Bobino is there to break it up.
And another big stop by the Texas defense, because I don't know how many opportunities this Texas El Paso offense is going to get, because this Texas offense will start executing here again before long.
Back to the recruiting thing. So is Friday Night Lights, is it really like that, like the movie?
You love that show.
I never miss an episode.
You love that show. Yeah, it really is. I mean, the excitement level, even in the small towns of Texas on Friday nights, it's quite a scene.
Here's the punt, and Amato gets it off. Fair catch called back at the 17 by Cosby, a 42-yard punt. And here's Mike Tirico with more on Monday night. Looking forward to seeing Darren McFadden. Put up big numbers last year at Arkansas. This is Fonzie Whitaker, brought down by Adam Vinson. Get to see Jamarcus Russell at the quarterback, too, for Oakland.
Some high-profile draft picks with the Raiders. And you know Al Davis isn't going to be real patient when you go out and get Jamarcus Russell and Darren McFadden. So big, big year for Lane Kiffin, obviously, at Oakland.
6:20 to go in the third quarter. Hand off once again, and Fonzie Whitaker right between the tackles for the first down, brought down by Ferguson.
You really see the burst, don't you, of Fonzie Whitaker. Great quickness, and you kind of get the feeling that Texas is going to put this game right now on these offensive linemen and try to settle the passing game down a little bit and settle Colt McCoy down. That was a big old gaping hole right there, though.
First down and 10. Whitaker again. He keeps his legs moving well. Trying to move the pile and got out to about the 38-yard line. Getting back to Colt McCoy and his leadership. Coming off what some would consider a great year, but for Colt McCoy, a down year last year, just 22 touchdown passes versus 18 interceptions. I asked him about one of the turning points in his young career so far. He said, you know, he looks back at a time right after the national championship when Vince Young came up to him and said, hey, for next year, you let this locker room, you let the team, your teammates know that you're the man, you're in charge. That was McGee on the run. And McGee is brought down at about the 43-yard line. Now, Bob, that's easy for Vince Young to say. How does Colt McCoy do that?
Well, how about following Vince Young? I mean, Vince Young, 30-2, just a remarkable, remarkable athlete. And here's Colt McCoy from a town of 714 people that, with a baby face, steps in to start as a freshman.
On the toss, this is McGee, and he's chopped down behind the line of scrimmage by Adam Vinson. Vincent, a transfer from Arizona State, arguably the best player on that defensive unit. He's the one guy, one of a couple guys that picked up that 3-3-5 alignment.
Well, and Adam Vinson, I have to tell this story because I know you're a fan of NBC's Biggest Loser.
Okay.
His sister, Allie, won that thing.
Wow.
You remember Allie?
Yeah.
I think it was just a year ago she won it.
That's his sister, huh?
That's his sister on NBC's Biggest Loser, the winner.
He was
biggest
a winner
loser
on
the win.
He was a winner on that play, Bob, because it sets up a fourth and two for Texas. They're forced to punt here. Oh boy, what a great punt that time by John Gold. Drives it inside the five, takes a minor bounce out to the 11-yard line, but still a great effort by punter John Gold. A 47.
The athletic director here, who has done just a remarkable job, Mark, with these facilities.
Right.
I mean, their facilities, as we look at Ryan Palmer shaking up on that play, their facilities here at UTEP are as nice as anywhere we've been. I'm talking about the weight room, which overlooks this stadium, the locker room, the coaches' offices. They have done a tremendous job here at the Sun Bowl. I think the next thing is to replace this artificial surface will be the next step for them.
Yeah, they have the facilities and resources here that can match most of any other school. And we got a nice tour of the facilities yesterday. I was unable to cash in on that offer for a free workout in the weight room this morning, Bob.
I noticed you did get a free pair of UTEP Miner shorts, I saw you carrying out of it.
Hit the treadmill pretty well.
You use the same story every week with the equipment manager. You left your shorts.
Oh, you just put me out there now.
I mean, everywhere we have been,
forgot
you
a pair
end
of
up
shorts.
With a free pair of shorts.
First and 10. Benito looking downfield, and it's caught. McGee was one option, and Adams made the catch.
That was a great catch by Chris Adams. He's their fastest wide receiver. The ball was actually a little late getting there, but he goes up over the top of Deion Beasley and makes the play. Deion Beasley not quite prepared to jump right there. That's the big play UTEP needed, Mark.
Adams, you mentioned the fastest receiver on the field, 4.4 speed in the 40-yard dash. Picked up 36. Neither team has scored here in the third quarter. Jackson on the draw. And Jackson got about four, close to five on the play. Terrell Jackson, the transfer from Oregon.
You've heard this. Every game you've ever done where there's a big underdog, you let that big underdog just keep hanging around. Late at night out here in El Paso, Texas, this momentum has changed now. Okay. Texas on offense, UTEP's finally able to slow them down a little bit.
The Miners have a sniff of success, and this is a college football landscape littered with upsets this early in the season. Pitt, Texas A&M, Mississippi State, and West Virginia all have been upset. On the screen, Jackson. Chopped down on the play by number 11, Jared Norton. Got 1 yard on the play. Third down coming up now for the Miners. What do you like here in terms of a call, Bob?
I like four down territory if I'm Mike
Really?
Weiss. I roll the dice a little bit here in the fact that I say I'm going to go for it on fourth down. So you may run the football, even though I doubt they will. Probably an option route to Jeff Maturi, number 6. A little quick throw right here.
And of course, he always has the option of going for a field goal because Jose Martinez has that strong leg we documented in the first half. Vitito under some heat. Oh, and he gives up a sack, which effectively takes them out of field goal range now. Brian Aracpo, the former Big 12 Defensive Freshman of the Year, an All-American candidate.
That was a great effort by Brian Aracpro. Watch him lined up at right defensive end right here. This is just a great effort move right here. He is actually doubled. They left the back end to chip on him, spins out of there and makes the sack.
And now they'll have to punt from their own 32-yard line.
Texas has come awfully close tonight, Mark, to blocking one of these punts.
Several times. Takes a minor bounce. Will they down it? Oh, unable to get there in time. And it'll come back out to the 20-yard line. We mentioned Brian Aracpo, the stud up front. Bench presses over 500 pounds, squats 600, deadlifts 380. And ESPN, the magazine, and ESPN.com actually have him ranked as one of the top defensive linemen in the country.
Came in at 210 pounds. now weighs 260, a fifth-year senior, probably their best NFL prospect right now. Great opportunity on that last series for UTEP. Did not take advantage of it.
Neither team has scored here in the third quarter. McCoy fires incomplete. That one intended for Quan Cosner to be second down and 10.
Big series right here, obviously, for both teams. But can this Texas offense get back on rhythm? Things have gone unbelievably well for Colt McCoy early in the season. This is the first adversity he's had in this young season.
That pass complete for the first down. Number five, Brandon Collins. And they move the chains. He missed last week's game with an administrative error. Had some paperwork that had to be worked out. Unable to play, but makes the first down there.
UTEP put a new corner in the game, Clarence Ward. Look how far he's going to line off right here. And this is just like stealing right here. Just a little slant right there.
First down and 10. McCoy pulling the trigger, incomplete, broken up by Clarence Ward. Intended once again for Brandon Collins.
Little surprised, Mark, that Texas doesn't line up and just run that football a little bit. I know the passing game's there. I know they feel like they can work on these El Paso corners, but you'd love to see that big offensive line just take this game over right now.
Yeah, you talk about the strength of those Texas players. Much of the credit going to Jeff Madden, a.k.a. Mad Dog, the strength and conditioning coach. And here's Fozzie Whitaker with a nice burst, still on his feet. Whitaker across midfield. And a first down, and that's exactly what you were alluding to, Bob, lining up and socking somebody right in the kisser.
Well, and the reason I say that, number one, they're a lot bigger than UTEP, but watch Texas El Paso, how they jump around. They're always moving, so they're not real strong at the point of attack. So you kind of catch those defensive line moving, and there's just some gaping holes up in there.
Picked up 15 on that run. 20 seconds to go in the third quarter. McCoy fires complete. Cosby once again.
What happens now? UTEP doesn't want to get up and play tight man-to-man, so they're playing off. Texas going to a lot of the quick slants. As you see, Ose Lewis over there upset with those DBs for playing off.
That was the eighth reception of the game for Cosby. This minor defense has been stout in the second half so far. That pass incomplete, short. Might have been the worst pass that Colt McCoy has fired tonight.
You can just imagine Ose Lewis coming from New Mexico as a defensive coordinator. They had tremendous success. He coached under Rocky Long up there. High expectations. They put together a very fine financial package for him to come. Gave him total control of the defense. And they really struggled last week. So this is a big game just for people to get some confidence in Ose here.
Trying to straighten it out a little bit. Collins on the reception. Breaks one tackle. And pushed out of bounds to the 33-yard line. That's the end of the third quarter. Under the lights here at the Sun Bowl. The biggest night since the Stones came to town. Sometimes you get what you want, and sometimes you get. Tonight's game between number 10 Texas and UTEP on ESPN2 is also available in sparkling high definition on ESPN2 HD. Now, Bob, can I borrow your telestrator here?
Sure.
See this couple right here? How do you ask your girl, hey, baby, can I take you to the game, and then you take her up to the Rock? You know? It's not like you got privacy up there either.
Man, it was like you're having a great time. What a great setting, though, in between these mountains. Mark Jones, you like this setting, don't you? Southwest. Big third down right here now.
Start of the fourth quarter, third and four for Texas.
Here they come.
They're 1-5 on third downs. McCoy up top, and Shipley couldn't turn around to get it.
Well, they're going to get him for offsides, though. Another great job by Colt McCoy holding that cadence.
Boy, you never want to give it to him too easily.
Yeah. That's an experienced quarterback.
Offside. Defense number 93. That's a 5-yard penalty. It is first down.
Corey Robinson, the culprit that time.
Torrey Robinson, as you mentioned earlier, just eligible yesterday, playing in the game tonight. But just those little things that don't show up in the game stats, game management by Colt McCoy. Tremendous job. And let's face it, for UTEP to beat Texas, they have to play darn near perfect. They cannot make as many mistakes as they've made tonight in this game.
Here's Whitaker, and he's stomped up at the line of scrimmage. James O'Loughlin. UTEP comes in 0-1 after losing last week up in Buffalo. Meanwhile, Texas last week winning at home against FAU, coming into the game 1-0 and ranked number 10. And by most accounts on the national scene, a little bit under the radar.
He sees one-on-one coverage up here at the top with Quan Cosby. Let's see right here if he just goes and takes a shot, Mark.
Looking that way, and Cosby couldn't hang on to it. And we have a flag thrown as Melvin Stevenson was defending.
I think Melvin Stevenson grabbed the jersey of Quan Cosby. Let's look at it. Just bump and run. Yeah, a little tug on that shirt. You have to make that call.
Defensive pass interference, number 4 of the defense. That's a spot foul. It is first down.
You better have corners, regardless of what kind of defense you play. But if you play this defense, you have to have great corners, because they are on their own.
When you say this defense, you're just joining us. It's the 3-3-5 alignment that Osei Lewis has brought in here.
Give credit to UTEP's defense, so they are battling. They're making Texas earn everything they get in this second half.
Whitaker, the deep back, dotting the eye. Shipley in motion. And Whitaker with nowhere to go. Jaboy Leomidi making the stop on the play.
Watch the penetration right here. You're going to see him lined up over the offensive guard, number 74, Ulatowski. Excellent penetration. How about that hair, huh?
Leomidi, actually last week in the loss against Buffalo, graded out the best of all the defensive linemen.
That's about as thick as I've ever seen the hair in football. Have you ever seen one like that?
that's Mark, more than Palomalu.
Talk about covering the name. That almost covers the entire number. Is that legal?
Plays like his hair's on fire, though. Welcome back, everyone, to the Sun Bowl in El Paso, Texas. Texas leading 28-13. Right now, deep in minor territory at the 16-yard line. This the 10th play of the Longhorn drive. Fonzie Whitaker, the lone back beside quarterback Colt McCoy. Second and 14. McCoy looking up top, wide open. What a fake! And they bought it. Shipley with the touchdown.
They faked the jailbreak screen. Watch Shipley right here. He's going to act like he's going to go out and block on the jailbreak. Then he's going to break it up the field. They thought it was going to be the wide receiver screen, El Paso, and they bit. Watch right there. He just turns it up and beats Anthony Morrow. Wow.
And for McCoy, the 58th touchdown pass of his career, which ties Chris Sims for number 2 on the school passing list.
They tried to jump the jailbreak, and it bit him.
I mean, they bought all of it, Bob, baby. They bought all of it. They got the receipt. They got everything. Colt McCoy with his 4th touchdown pass of the night. And Jordan Shipley. Boy, that's room service. To El Paso, Texas. Texas leading 35-13 after that 10-play, 80-yard drive using 2:27 on the clock. And Jordan Shipley right there with a touchdown catch from Colt McCoy, his 4th of the night.
I tell you, this Big 12 conference has gone crazy throwing the football, huh?
Oh. We saw Missouri last week. They pitch and catch pretty well, and lots of good things happening at Texas not only on the field here, but back at the school, Darrell K. Royal Memorial Stadium. That's what it used to look like, and they've had an expansion in the north end zone. It now features an upper deck and club seating.
I mean, you have to do that. You talk about the arms race and facilities. You've been to College Station and seen those facilities. Now Oklahoma State with T. Boone Pickens and what they've done. Plus, these high schools in this state have such great facilities. If you're going to go recruit those guys, you better have the best of the best. And Texas has a tremendous, tremendous facility stadium right there.
And Jackson put it on the ground. He fumbled it, recovered by McElroy. And McElroy got the touchdown. And Jackson is hurt. A 25-yard run by McElroy on the fumble recovery.
Yes, Sam Achoa, number 81, stripped that football out of there. And Roderick McElroy showed some speed. But watch Achoa, 91, right there. Great effort play. McElroy picks it up and takes it to the house.
McElroy from Hallsville, Texas. There's the fumbling. Jackson was shaken up. He got bent around pretty awkwardly, Bob. Lawrence with the extra point, good. And you could feel the wind leave the collective sails of the Miners on that last play. Jackson being helped off the field. Mack Brown has won more games than any other school during the last 10 years. And defensively, they've been really intransigent. I mean, tough to move.
And you know, Will Muschamp, the third defensive coordinator in 3 years at Texas. Now, the good news, most of those defensive coordinators become head coaches. You look at Greg Robinson at Syracuse, Gene Chizik up at Iowa State. Will Muschamp, a young, fiery guy. You talk about a great pedigree. At LSU with Nick Saban, then with the Dolphins with Nick, then went to Auburn with Tommy Tuberville. Played at the University of Georgia, where he got to know Greg Davis, Texas offensive coordinator, was on the staff there.
Yeah, we haven't talked much about Greg Davis tonight. Boy, the play selection calling certainly has been beyond reproach tonight when you look at the number of points on the board and the efficiency of the quarterback, Colt McCoy.
Well, Greg Davis has done a tremendous job. It wasn't that long ago that the fans were clamoring for Mack Brown to make a change as far as the offensive coordinator. You see Greg sitting right there. But he stuck with Greg Davis. They're great friends, and it's really worked out well. He's done a tremendous job with his offense.
Tucker on the kickoff. Fry on the return. Out over the 20-yard line. Defensively, boy, Texas has been staunch tonight.
Well, you see their speed, you see their explosiveness, you see their athletic ability. Again, to me, it's going to come down to how complex can they be in the secondary against these very complex offenses in the Big 12, because they are so young. But there's no question he brings some fire, right?
Energy. Palmer in the ballgame now for UTEP. James Thomas in the game. This is Thomas on the carry. Well, he's got some wheels, and nice gain of about 5 or 6 on the play.
There's always a fine line. You talk about Will Muschamp. How much do you do on defense without making it too complicated for these young DBs? But you know you have to have enough scheme, because if you're too simple against these real good passing offenses in the Big 12, they're going to carve you. But if you do too much, you confuse yourself. So it is a fine line with how much defense they implement.
Yeah, you look at him dealing with the young safeties that you speak of, Bob. They have had a lot of good players move on to the NFL from the secondary. Second and 4. That pass complete. Adams still on the move. And finally brought down by Acho. And boy, you look at the guys on defense in the secondary. Quentin Jammer now in the NFL. Michael Huff right there with them. Big hits from Cedric Griffin. And Michael Griffin, also in the NFL, Aaron Ross, whose fiance just happens to be one of the fastest females on the planet.
Yeah, he's Sonny with Richards. The New York Giants. She was at practice.
Yeah.
I heard John Madden talking about her being at practice. He was quite impressed.
Won the bronze medal at the Olympics recently in Beijing. One of my neighbors down in Fort Lauderdale. I'd like to drop a few names, Bob. I hope you don't mind. That pass incomplete. Bobineau right there. Maturi, the intended receiver. Second down and 10 coming up. And this is a night for Mike Price and the minor fans and following that held so much promise to begin with. They scored the first 6 points of the ball game, but after that, boy, Texas responded with three quick touchdowns.
Say one thing, these fans stick around here in this stadium.
A pass by Vitito complete into Texas territory to his tight end, Jamar Hunt. Hunt, an interesting story. You see that big wrap that he has on his left hand. He does have good hands. A Mormon who did his mission in Mexico a couple of years ago. One of a couple married players on the team. His wife is 5 months pregnant, so congratulations to the Hunts. A couple of older brothers that played at UTEP as well. Third down and 3 coming up for UTEP. Vitito complete. And down to the 23, it's James Thomas. Thomas has really brought something to the table tonight. 5'11", 185-pound sophomore.
Boy, some quickness right there. You take a look at Blake Gideon. That time, Blake Gideon, the safety in man-to-man coverage on Thomas, which these five wide receiver sets that UTEP was in, they make that safety have to cover, and you better get ready for that because Missouri is on Texas' schedule. They're going to see that about 45 or 50 snaps, that no-back look.
Yeah, we saw Chase Daniel last week really carve up that Illinois secondary for a while.
Timeout, UTEP, they're first of the half.
You talk about the quarterbacks in the Big 12. I mean, there have to be, there's 8 or 9 legitimate quarterbacks. Team spread to field. We didn't put on there Cody Hawkins at Colorado.
Right.
Big Freeman at Kansas State. McGee at A&M's played a lot of football.
And you look at the numbers, Bob, that each of those aforementioned quarterbacks put up today. Man, 410 yards passing for Reesing. And Bradford with 395. Daniel, a modest 244. Complete. Man, Johnny Moore absorbed the hit and stayed on his feet.
Yeah, Eddie
Got
Jones,
the first down.
Another speed defensive end outside rusher. Eddie Jones and Sam Achoa, two undersized guys at defensive end that are going to play a lot of football. You know what his nickname is?
Tell me.
Bad Dream. See it right there?
I like that. Bad Dream. Second down and 2 coming up. Vitito, a little backside heat coming, incomplete. Tried to find number 19, Evan Davis, on the play.
And it's amazing in college football. And it's been well documented, it's not a secret. As we get a penalty here on UTEP, the salaries of the coordinators now in college football. You know, Will Muschamp comes to Texas. I believe they're paying him $425,000 to leave Auburn and come, signs a multi-year contract. I mean, and it makes sense.
Michael Oxley last week at Illinois.
I think he's making $500,000 that was reported.
Yeah.
But you know, it makes sense. I mean, when you're putting a guy like Will Muschamp in charge of this defense at Texas, it's well worth the investment. And the market has driven it because to be competitive, you have to pay it.
Second down and 12 after the holding penalty for 10 yards. Vitito intercepted at the 13. It's picked off by Ryan Palmer, the nickelback who had an interception last week against FAU. One of the real pleasant surprises defensively in that secondary for the Longhorns.
And Mike Price, last year, Vitito, Mark, one interception in every 58 passes. This one may have hit the ground, though. Let's take a look at this.
Well, unless he trapped it while his back was to us. Otherwise, he cradled that ball, seemed to have his arms underneath it. Timeout on the field. We'll be back. Well, that last interception is now under review. Ryan Palmer appeared to have the interception, but upon further review, Bob, it looks like the ball hit the ground.
Yeah, Mark, I think you're going to see right there the nose of that football bounced off that turf. Now, Ryan Palmer did a great job of just getting up off that ground, sprinting over there to the sidelines, but right there you see that toe of that ball hit the ground.
Yeah, UTEP's offense is going to be back on the field after this one.
They're just trying now to retain the spot and get the correct down and distance.
Here's the call.
After review, previous play was incomplete. It'll be third down at the 25.
That's why you had it.
Yeah. Should have used it on that Washington BYU game today.
Boy.
I don't know how that official called that. I know it's in the rule book. You're not allowed to throw the ball in the air, but the spirit of that rule.
I mean, Jake Locker takes it in to make it 28-27. He bounces off the ground. Really no predetermined celebration. Didn't embarrass any opponents, but he did flip the ball up in the air.
Still a
excessive celebration penalty. Then they get the extra point.
Yeah.
Block.
So spontaneous. Third down and 12 coming up here.
Mentioned last year, Vitito, only one interception per 58 attempts. Only seven interceptions all last year. Been a little reckless with the football so far this season.
Not sure exactly what they're waiting on. Third and 12 coming up. Vitito under some heat and sacked back at the 37-yard line. Sergio Kindle there leading the way defensively for Texas.
Yeah, Arakpo and Kindle, number 2 and number 98. Some excellent pass rush and excellent effort. That will help them in the Big 12. And I really like Sergio Kindle as a pass rusher.
Martinez is going to come in, Bob, and try and attempt a field goal. This one is going to be spotted at the 42-yard line.
Yeah, very little wind. It better hurry up, though. That clock is winding down. It's going to be a 57-yard attempt before long.
52, and Martinez misses this one. Had enough leg, but pushed it off to the right. Now one of three on the night. Pardon me, two of four on the night. Of course, one of those from 65 yards out. Let's take a look at tonight's auto.
I think you're going to see a lot of that throughout this college football season for Longhorns.
Well, Greg Davis had an interesting conversation with him prior to the season on this carry. This is Cody Johnson, and Johnson gets about 4 yards on the play. Back to Colt McCoy. You know, after his freshman year, who's on the sideline now, of course, Greg Davis, the offensive coordinator, called him and said, you know, I know you're a freshman of the year, but don't go seeing ghosts this season. Don't overanalyze everything. Just go out there and play your game. And last year, they admit that they maybe put a little bit too much on him. This year, have simplified it a little bit more for him. Johnson once again on the running play. Gained 7 on the play. John Childs now in a quarterback for Longhorns. Does every kid in Texas have his dad coach him in high school football?
Boy,
or does
right.
It just seem that way?
It seems like this Texas program, there are a bunch of coaches' sons out there playing. I'm anxious to watch John Childs here. Played very well last week, 4 or 5 passing. a runner first. But, you know, Mac Brown wants to get his best players on the field. John Childs is one of their best players.
Riddick makes the stop on Johnson. 8.5 minutes to go. The clock winding down.
Built a little bit in the same number as Juice Williams at Illinois. Same body type, big, strong guy.
I saw Juice last week put up great numbers against that Missouri defense, Bob. Earning him Big Ten Offensive Player of the Week honors. Second and 11 coming up here. Same play to Cody Johnson.
Pretty good night for McCoy. 20 of 29, 282 yards, 4 touchdowns. Some great statistics for Colt starting this season.
Yeah, he's got, I guess, 7 touchdowns on the season now against just 1 interception.
Can you imagine coming from a town of 714?
There's a place, Tuscola, Texas, a place where the mayor there also runs the local funeral home.
Wow.
That's small town. Here's Giles.
You pulled out some nuggets on me. You've been waiting to use that all night.
You never want to get too close to that funeral.
You don't want to get on the wrong side of
no,
that.
No, no, not at all. He might be the sheriff, too. I'm not sure. 7:09 to go.
All right, Colt, keep your mind on the game now.
Colt McCoy. Great numbers tonight.
You have to give UTEP credit, though, Mark. I think they played hard tonight. You know, last week, such a disappointing loss up at Buffalo. I think they've represented themselves well. I mean, they had some opportunities in this game. Texas clearly the better team. That goes without saying, particularly Texas's offense against UTEP's defense. But they played hard. There's a bunch of football left for this UTEP team.
On the offense, 5-yard penalty. It is 4 down.
UTEP going to try and have to get its mojo back somehow, Bob, because going back to last year, should things not change so far tonight, then they will have lost 8 consecutive games.
Yeah, that a lot. You know, I didn't realize that coming in here. But 8 straight losses. You're right.
All of a sudden, that warm and fuzzy 8-4 season, Mike Price's first year, becomes a distant memory. But, you know, we sense that they weren't down on this program or their staff. We got into town. Ball bounces out of bounds inside the 10-yard line, and a huge week coming up next week on the ESPN family of networks. Ohio State, number 3, taking on number 1, USC. And after that scare, Bob, that Ohio State had today against Ohio, man, what do you make of that one?
Yeah, I mean, so much depends, obviously, on Chris Wells in his health. But I think also, you know, deep down, I mean, I know Ohio State has great pride, but do they really think they can win? You know, after the last 2 BCS championship games, going out, they get another marquee game out there. I know a lot of the fans around the country don't think Ohio State can win.
Ooh, nice move here by Palmer. Check that. Thomas. And Thomas with a great burst.
You can see why he was a great option quarterback in high school. Everybody wanted to recruit him, but they wanted to make him a corner. He came to UTEP because they told him he could be at least a part-time quarterback.
He picked up 26 yards in a blink that time. 6:19 to go. And Muschamp still doing his thing.
Look at those eyes.
Bidito out as a receiver. Thomas taking the snap now for UTEP. And a flag.
I think Vidito lined up off sides.
Was he running early? Was he running a 9 route or something? Going deep?
Full starts. Number 19 of the offense. 5-yard penalty.
That was E.V. Davis. Yeah, Vidito, though, he needs to just stay on side because he's just a decoy. But Mike Price told us yesterday, you know, he's been here. This is his 5th season. 8 straight losses. Last week after the Buffalo game, the first even semi-heat he's had here in town. I mean, that was such a disappointing loss for him, but they have embraced Mike Price here in El Paso.
Bidito completes the pass to his tight end, Jamar Hunt.
But I'll tell you,
that was Russell Carr.
You go back to next week's games, it was a little light today, the schedule across the country. But next week, I think there are some great football games.
Notre Dame, Michigan, another one of those on the docket.
That face says it all right there, doesn't it? I've played a lot of golf with him. We've lost a lot of golf balls. I promise you, we have lost a lot of golf balls today.
He's got to win the 19th hole. That's all that counts, Bob. On the handoff, Thomas keeps it himself. What do you think? Is Mike Price getting a look at a little different package here?
You know, it's really not Mike Price's style. You know, he's been the one-back, three-wide receiver, drop-back passing game forever. But with everybody else in college football going to this zone-to-side type game, all of a sudden, you know, James Thomas gives you a completely different changeup. But it's just tough to practice it all, yeah. You know.
Under 5 minutes to go now. Gain of about 7 on the play. That was number 22, Daniel Palmer.
Up to the 44-yard line of the Miners.
Interesting. We had Terrell Jackson leave the game a little bit earlier. I don't think that we've seen him since. He appeared to have some sort of leg injury. Pickup of 7 that time by Daniel Palmer. On 2nd down and 3. Hunt in motion. Hunt makes the catch with that cast on his left hand and is brought down right around the first down marker at the 41-yard line. Look at how big and thick and cumbersome that thing is.
I think that last tackle was number 27, Nolan Brewster, who is the son of the head coach of the Minnesota Gophers, another freshman, a defensive back. His dad, Tim, was an assistant for Mack Brown, now is the head coach at Minnesota. So this is a true freshman from Denver, Colorado right here, and Nolan Brewster.
And good news for Nolan is that his dad's team, Minnesota, defeated Bowling Green
easily
today.
That's a big win. That's a big, big win.
3rd down and 1. They get the first down. Vitadeau keeps it himself. We talked about Jamar Hunt being married and his wife being 5 months pregnant. What about Trevor Vitadeau, who was married this past spring to his high school sweetheart? Always nice when you have a little married company on the field, you know, on the team. He and Jamar Hunt, maybe they have married students night. Married players night. 3:05 to go.
This will be a late night for the Longhorns. Flying back to Austin, they lose an hour. They'll probably get back about 3 or 4.
Vitadeau going up top. And incomplete at the 12-yard line. That intended for James Thomas. Well, at 11 downfield we've seen tonight right there, Bob.
Guy's checking his messages.
Vitadeau. Nice move and flat by Daniel Palmer, the freshman out of College Station, Texas.
Big win for the Aggies today. Bouncing back from that loss to Arkansas State, go into Albuquerque, beat New Mexico. Sets up an open date, and then the Miami Hurricanes come to Kyle Field and College Station.
Maybe Miami able to defeat Texas A&M last year down in Coral Gables. And Miami losing today against Florida, snapping their winning streak against the Gators. Vitadeau back to pass. Finds a man, Hunt, and Hunt lunging for the first down. Interesting happenings in the Big 12. Conference's teams are 21-2 in non-conference play so far, 2 weeks into the college football season. They went 11-0 today.
Yeah, you know, 7 Big 12 teams offensively ranked in the top 25 last year in all of college football. 7 Big 12 teams in the top 25 on offense. There was only one defense in the top 25. Guess which one? Which Big 12 school?
Kansas.
I thought you were going to say Oklahoma. Kansas had the highest rated defense in the Big 12.
Number two of the offense, 5-yard penalty. It is first down.
Okay, who do you like right now? We had Missouri last week. We have Texas tonight. They play a little later in the early part of the season. Do you like Texas or do you like Missouri?
That's an interesting thought. Boy, that's a 41-38 game either way.
Could be.
And for whatever reason, I think Texas has a little more depth on offense. That one knocked away. And of course, a lot of it depends on Jeremy Maclin and how he comes back from that little ankle injury that he suffered.
Exactly.
Second down and 15 coming up.
Yeah, we're going to get a rough in the passer here.
15-yard penalty. It is first down.
Wow. Yeah, talked about Eddie Jones, just a young sophomore out of Kilgore. I'm not sure he realized, obviously, the ball had been released. Great opportunity, though, for young guys to play. I mean, when it's 42-13, you can make those corrections. You can get away with some mistakes.
First and 10 from the 18 for UTEP, who will fall to 0-2 on the season. Longhorns, conversely, will improve to 2-0. This is the 10th play of the drive. Bitado into the end zone, into double coverage. And incomplete in the back of the end zone. Brewster there on the coverage along with Williams. 1:03 to play. You know, Bob, I have one regret. And this has been a great couple of days here in the city of El Paso. They have really rolled out the carpet for us and welcomed us with open arms. But the one thing I regret about this weekend, I thought you would hook me up with a nice place with a chicken fried steak. You know, but you tell me that's more like...
That's more back in...
Back East Texas?
Central East Texas,
okay.
Yeah. I thought you were going to say you didn't get a pair of ostrich skin boots while you were...
I got that already, man. I got snake, I got ostrich, you know. I got it like that. Nice play that time from the safety spot, shooting in there to make the stop. Frazier on the carry, meanwhile. And that was Acho coming in to make the stop on the play for Texas. 54 seconds to go. UTEP calls timeout on third down and 8. I'm Mark Jones along with Bob Davey here at the Sun Bowl. This is the first time that Texas has played here during the regular season. As we look at Mike Price, what do they do now moving forward? Where do they concentrate their efforts, Bob, to get themselves squared away going into their conference schedule?
Yeah, I mean, I think you just build on the positives of this game. Much better effort tonight than they had last week. There were some positives in this game. I mean, at times on offense, they moved the ball pretty well. They actually came to life defensively a little bit in the second half. They continued to shoot themselves and make too many mistakes. But I love Mike Price's concept of having the windshield in the meeting room. You come back tomorrow, you watch the tape, and all of a sudden you put that windshield wiper on and wipe this one clean because there is a lot of football left. But, you know, they're in a tough league. I mean, that Conference USA, I mean, look up now what East Carolina's doing.
Yeah, they were picked, UTEP was third by the prognosticators in the conference. East Carolina upsetting Virginia Tech and then another big win today. Movement there by the right guard.
But you know, you look at Mike Price over on that sideline. He's standing there thinking all those things you just asked me. You know, he went through a whole period there thinking, okay, what am I going to say to this team after the game? What am I going to say to the media? What's my plan? What's my plan moving forward as I regroup this football team?
I think I need more than a windshield wiper.
He's getting tired, man. That wiper's getting worn out when he lost 8 straight.
A little more Windex on that bad boy. Bitado had the ball tipped at the line of scrimmage, incomplete. There's 51 seconds to go. Fourth down and 13 coming up.
I don't think he'll try that field goal right there. Right here.
Think back to field goals. And that was that field goal attempt from 65 yards out that was short and was run back 65 yards by Quan Cosby. There's Jose Martinez, who has enough leg to make a 65-yard field goal. Has made a 70-yard field goal in practice. But Cosby ran it back 65 yards.
Practice.
We talk about practice.
I've hit a lot of good drives on that driving range, too.
Made complete. And that was intended for Palmer. Texas will take over on downs with 46 seconds to go in the game. Yeah, that was one of the turning points in the game.
It really was. It was a 14-6 game at that point. Try the long field goal. Quan Cosby with a heads-up play while 21 other players were spectators. He ran that thing back.
Well, the tickets for this game had sold out immediately, almost immediately after the game was announced some 2.5 years ago. And this is the biggest show to hit El Paso, arguably, since the Rolling Stones came to town a couple of years ago. Had a nice night last night, a pep rally. Minor Palooza is what they called it. 7,000 fans showed up at the arena for that night. We got to the stadium here, Bob, a couple of hours before kickoff, and the fans were having a great time tailgating. Really a festive atmosphere. You can hear a little hand clap now for the Miners, despite what's written on the scoreboard. And some of the claps coming for, well, frankly, there's some people from Austin that made the trip, too. Mac Brown's team improves to 2-0. And Mike Price and the Miners fall to 0-2. Colt McCoy with a huge night statistically, 20 of 29 for 282 yards and 4 touchdown passes, including the 58th of his career. Final score once again from El Paso, 42-13 for the Longhorns. Coming up next, World Series of Poker. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For Bob Davey and our entire talented crew behind the camera, you never get a chance to see. I'm Mark Jones. Good night from El Paso.